Welcome to Let's Talk Shop. My name is Ted Dirks. I'm the sales manager here for the Recycling and Forestry Group.
And I'm Jay Van Ruckel, product manager for the Recycling and Forestry Group.
And today we're excited to talk to you about the new TR6450. We've spent the better part of the last 3 years talking to you, our customers, about the challenges you face and really what it is you want in a trommel screen. And I think what we have here is pretty darn close. So let's dig into that. My first question is, how would you describe where you see this model fitting in our lineup, and who really is our target customer?
Ted, I believe the real target is a small to medium-sized producer running traditional trommel screen materials like compost, mulch, light aggregate soils, even the biofuels, biomass feedstocks. It's also good for a small footprint site. We can adjust the conveyor positioning and really fit to a small site.
Yeah, I think that's a good point. Our traditional trommels are very long and skinny, and this design is definitely more compact. So if you would, briefly give us the rundown on the numbers of the engine, horsepower, drum size, and the overall machine weight.
Sure. It's a Caterpillar 3.6 liter. It puts out 120 horsepower. It's dual labeled, so we can sell into Tier 4 Final or Stage 5 compliant countries. It has a 6.5-foot diameter drum by 20 foot long. It also has a 6.5-foot cubic yard hopper and weighs in around 39,000 pounds.
All right, very good. So when we were scoping out this project, what were some of the core design pillars we were thinking about as we went through it?
Ease of setup, ease of maintenance, ease of operation. Low hopper height feeding. Yeah. You know, we're at 9.5 feet, so most loaders can feed the trommel without building a ramp. Mm-hmm. We have our tension screen drum design, which allows a lot of flexibility, but we can also run auger or punch plate type yeah. drums.
Good point. And of course, the three product design is also a huge, huge aspect as well. So let's talk more about those maintenance friendly features. What are those more specifically?
So the engine swing out. So a customer can maintain his engine, change filters, et cetera, do his oil changes without being in awkward positions. We have independent brushes on all of our screen panels, so we can make fine-tune adjustments without wearing out the entire brush. A unique drum drive. So we've changed from the wraparound type chain to drive a drum to a chain and cog type drive system.
Yeah.
So that also makes it easier for drum swaps, et cetera, but less wear parts.
Yeah.
And ground level lubrication, I think, is also important. You know, we want them to maintain our product without getting in awkward positions or getting ladders.
Right. Very good. So when it comes to productivity of screening, obviously the drum size makes the biggest difference. But what are some of the other design aspects we've taken into consideration to take advantage of that the productivity with this drum size?
Our unique tension screen drum is unique to the industry and gives our customers the most flexibility as possible. The screen panel themselves can be made of various gauge of wire, also different types of wire. So if you're running wetter things, you may want to run a stainless type wire,
yeah.
As well as the variety of hole opening sizes to match what your end product needs to be.
Yep, a lot of versatility there. So I want to talk a little more specifically about our quick change screen, because that's definitely a huge feature. What does that really mean for our customers?
So it allows them to just stock some screen panels if they want a variety of end products, right. versus stocking a complete drum. Yeah. So the screen panel themselves can be changed out very efficiently.
Yeah.
There's a panel wraps around half the drum. And on this particular machine, there's four different sections. So there'd be 8 screens that they would need to have or change.
And I've even seen customers mix and match, maybe using a slightly smaller screen towards the back half of the drum as the material gets screened out to maintain quality while still trying to be productive. I think the other key thing is our customers also have lots of different applications and markets to serve. And so being able to change out the screens and not having to invest in an entire second drum is a huge feature. So I want to move on and talk more about the three product option. Trommel screens don't traditionally have a three product option. So why did we develop this, and where do we see this option fitting in the market? Who is kind of the ideal operation?
Yeah, we certainly see our big commercial operations utilizing some different types of screens that can do three product in one pass.
Yeah.
We believe that the medium to small operation needs the same flexibility, right? We're all trying to serve more markets or more end users so we can increase our business opportunities. So allowing a trommel screen to do three products is very unique to the industry.
Yeah.
So we believe it's one pass, multiple product, and gives flexibility on your end product size as well, right? By changing screen panels. So
yeah,
we can allow our customers to get really flexible, meeting multiple needs in the market.
So what specifically are some of the applications we've seen success with in three products?
Compost comes to mind. You know, if you're doing residential or maybe nursery applications, they'll want a really fine product.
Yeah.
If you're doing more ag applications, they like a little bulkier product to have a little more staying power in the soil out in the field. So right there, you can do that in one pass. Mulch is another great example, especially coloring mulch. If you have too many fines, it really absorbs a lot of water and color and is more expensive. So you could run that product through a three-product trommel screen like the TR6450, remove the fines, focus in on coloring your mid-sized product and get the overs out so you can reprocess those and make them usable.
That's a good point. And like the quick change screen design, I think the three product also offers you quite a bit of versatility. You know, you don't always have to run it as a three product. Can you talk a little bit more about the switch between screening with three products to two?
Yeah, it's a switch in the program, right? To convert it from two to three products.
Yeah.
Gives that extra set of flexibility.
Yeah, yeah. And I also like, too, that fines conveyor. We've made it flexible enough to go off either the left or the right side, depending on your site. So finally, I want to talk about the controls, which I think is another really unique aspect of this machine. And this is where it all really comes together for the user experience and interacting with our machine. So what can you tell us about our control systems and how we approach the design of it?
So operation efficiency is critical, right? So we believe in the full function remote.
Yeah.
So an operator from the cab of the loader or a manager on site can make adjustments to that machine as conditions change or the machine needs slight tweaks to be better at running product through. So instead of having to go down to the machine, we can do that right from our remote. We also have presets, so for compost, for mulch, for wet compost versus dry compost, you can program in different settings into your machine that your operator can kind of punch a button and get things rolling in the morning and then make adjustments and fine tuning through the day.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the other thing I really like too is if there is an issue with the machine, that operator sitting in his cab can quickly go into the diagnostics menu, pull up the fault code and kind of see what's going on with the machine.
Yeah, good point. And another, I think, a neat feature is there are times through the day where the trommel's not going to be fed, right? He's loading a truck. The loader's busy doing other things. You can easily pause the machine, not burn that fuel, and then fire it back up, get it going at full RPM again when you're ready to go.
And I love it also from a safety aspect. If there is an issue, there's an e-stop in the remote with the operator in the cab. So a lot of great stuff there when it comes to our remote control. So that does it for us here. Thank you for tuning in. And thank you, Jay, for helping us unpack this new platform. If you have any further questions, please visit us at Vermeer.com or contact your local dealer. Thank you and have a great day.